South Korea is set to become the first country in the world to launch 5G services for all local customers. Out of that landmark occasion, service providers are showcasing how the super-fast mobile network can be used to advance driverless car technology. Oh Soo-young provides a glimpse of the not-so-distant future.
Driving in 5G has become a reality on the streets of Seoul. On Monday, A1, a driverless car developed by Hanyang University, successfully drove 8 kilometers in eastern Seoul using the next-generation 5G mobile network. It's the first time in the world that a self-driving vehicle has used 5G to drive on public roads among human drivers. Powered by mobile carrier LGU+, the vehicle was able to switch lanes, swerve around obstacles, and stream live footage of its journey without bugs or delays.
Current LTE systems make it difficult to pinpoint the exact location of the car due to delays of around 600 milliseconds. 5G can reduce this margin of error within 30 milliseconds. This revolutionary speed is expected to contribute greatly to the development of driverless vehicles.
LGU+ and Hanyang University's ACE Lab also plan to add 5G-based entertainment, including VR and AR content, to create a multidimensional travel experience. Using 5G's high-speed connectivity and the ultra-low latency, other network carriers are also showcasing the technology. KT Corporation earlier this year test drove a 10-seater 5G-equipped bus in the heart of the Korean capital. Each of the bus's seats comes with a VR headset, so passengers can find themselves among the cheering crowd at a baseball stadium, a K-pop concert, or at an amusement park with a virtual date.
Once driverless cars start hitting the road, passengers will have more time on their hands. So there will be a huge demand for infotainment content using 5G to process massive amounts of data in ultra-high speed.
Given Korea's plentiful bandwidth and infrastructure to enable 5G-based driving, it's no longer just a question of technological viability. As driverless cars get closer to commercialization by the day, service providers are now racing to provide optimized media services to win over customers. Woo Soo-young, Arirang News.